Welcome to episode 14 of my weekly training diaries series. And this week I'm coming to you from the Republic of Georgia. I'm currently in Kazbegi, officially known as Stepansminda, which is up near the Russian border. And I'm here for a couple of days to enjoy the mountains before I head back south and then on westward to explore more of the country. I already spent a couple of days in the capital, Tbilisi. I flew in on, it would have been Friday afternoon. I left Canada on Wednesday afternoon. It took me close to 2 days to get here. I had a flight cancellation and then that flight got delayed. Anyway, I finally made it on Friday afternoon and I had all day on Saturday to explore the city, to explore the old town. So in this video, I'll tell you a little bit more about what I've been up to this week in terms of both my training and planning for my upcoming race here in the country of Georgia, starting on Sunday. I'll also give you all of the information you'll need to follow along with me if you want to during the race. So as I said, on Saturday, the day after I arrived, I spent most of the day exploring the city, but then I squeezed in a tempo run in the afternoon. And as I said last week, when I'm tapering, my volume gets lowered quite a bit, but I still keep up the intensity. So we're still trying to maintain, you know, fitness and that neuromuscular connection. So that's what this tempo run was all about. So I did a few sets at 8 minutes tempo, followed by some shorter, harder intervals as well. And I did this along the riverfront in Tbilisi. It's a really hilly city, so really the only flat terrain I could find was down by the river. And then that evening, I joined a local running group, the Tbilisi Running Club, for a pasta dinner party. And they invited me to do a little bit of a presentation as well about my journey, that what brought me to Georgia, and to talk a little bit more about my race. And this was organized by my friend Irakli, who got in touch with me a few months ago and offered to help me here in Georgia. And he even picked me up from the airport. It was super convenient. And he's been helping me make some arrangements as well, like car rentals and things. And I met a bunch of people, some Georgians, a lot of expats as well. And then I joined them as well on Sunday morning for a little 12K trail race. And this was part of the Tbilisi Adventure Run put on by Trail Lab here in Georgia. They do a few different races around the country. And, you know, the trail running scene is really still developing here, but they seem to be at the forefront of this. And it was a really fun event, a really good chance for me to meet some more trail runners from the local community. Again, some Georgians, a lot of expats, and as well to get to see what the trails are like here in Georgia. We also had some amazing views of the city. This was basically just up on the ridge, maybe 15, 20 minutes outside of town. So I had a 90-minute run scheduled for that day anyway, which is why I figured I would jump into the 12K race. So I tried to hold back. I tried not to run too hard because it was supposed to just be a long run. But again, it was a great chance to get my scheduled run in. I think I ended up being a little bit short on time, closer to 75 minutes, but maybe at a little bit harder of an effort. So in the end, I think it was just fine. These trails are beautiful. And then pretty much right after that, I jumped in the car and made my way north here to Kazbegi. And so no running on the schedule today. I have a day off after that race yesterday. But tomorrow, after a long drive, I'm gonna be leaving Kazbegi and heading west. I will have a 45-minute kind of easy run to do. I'll probably just do that around town when I get to Katazi, which is the next city that I'm gonna be staying in for a few nights, for 3 nights, while I explore some of the sites around the city. And then on Wednesday, I have a 45-minute steady state run on the schedule, which is kind of like a race prep set. I talked about this last week. And so that'll be at maybe just below tempo effort. Thursday, I've got the day off. And then on Friday, I'll do another easy run of 45 minutes. And then I need to do race check-in and start prepping all my gear, because on Saturday, we leave for camp. And if I have time, I'm gonna do a quick 30-minute kind of shakeout run in the morning, just an easy run, and then we'll head to camp, and then we start the race on Sunday morning. So if you want to follow along with the race next week, as I said, it starts on Sunday and we'll be racing until the following Sunday, you can visit racingtheplanet.com/Georgia and look for the race updates. I'll post a link to this in the description below. And I believe they also have a newsletter that you can subscribe to in order to receive updates directly by email. I heard from a lot of people who really enjoyed following along with my race in Namibia, because Racing the Planet does a really good job of sort of telling the story of the race each day. And so you'll get to follow along with other runners as well. So there'll be no update next week, because of course I'll be racing. Then after that, I have a couple of more days to spend in the country, at which point I will film an update to let you all know how the race went. Georgia so far has been just an incredible experience. The country is beautiful. The people are super friendly, super helpful and welcoming. I'm really gonna enjoy putting this documentary together, and I think a lot of people are gonna be surprised, and you're gonna be adding this to your bucket list, I promise you. You're gonna wanna book a flight here as soon as possible. So you'll of course get to experience all of that through my lens in a couple of months when I'm done the series from the race. So wish me luck, and I will talk to you all when the race is done in about 2 weeks.